National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Indianapolis Colts and the Cleveland Browns under the lights on Sunday night.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to the home of rock and roll, Cleveland, Ohio, and Cleveland Browns Stadium. Mike Tirico, Greg Olson, glad to have you in the booth with us here on EA Sports. Hey, this is one of those intriguing matchups because we've got a couple of quarterbacks that most important position trying to bounce back after seasons where injury derailed their hopes for a good campaign.
And it's just so difficult when you look back on each of these teams' prior season just last year. It's hard to separate how much of their up and down, how much of their struggles was because of the injuries at the quarterback positions, whether they were in the game or just battling through on game day, or was it the rest of the roster? Well, I think with both of these quarterbacks now being healthy and back to looking like their old selves, we're going to get a lot better idea of just how good the rest of these rosters are now that their two quarterbacks are back on the field.
From the six, here comes a return. And it'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Browns led out by their quarterback, Deshaun Watson. The stardom early in Houston. Now his third season with the Browns, eighth season in the league, as Watson tries to get this Browns team going in this one.
There was a time, and it wasn't very long ago, Mike, that this guy was trending towards becoming one of the best quarterbacks in the entire NFL. He has to find a way to get back to stacking strong performances one after another and keep his team in the hunt. It'll be interesting to see how this one plays out, but if he plays well, his team is always going to have a strong chance of winning.
Oh, no, right at the start, he loses the football. And the defense has it.
So the biggest thing that stands out here, Mike, is the fact that the defense just continues to pursue to the ball. Every defense focuses on get as many hats to the ball carrier as possible, because if the guy in front of you, he misses the tackle or he falls down, you have to be there to make up for it. And the pursuit to the ball is not only how they're able to get him down, it's ultimately how they're able to take the ball away.
Indianapolis led out by their quarterback, Anthony Richardson, the number four overall pick in 2023, had some highlight moments, but injured most of the year. Greg, now in his second year in the NFL out of Florida.
I don't know if you saw it, Mike, but as the quarterback was taking the field, he took an extra couple seconds to thank his defense as they made their way to the sideline. Not only giving him the ball, but giving him the ball on what is a short field. Now, can he lead this offense and take advantage of the takeaway? You get a gift to start the game. Now you got to come away with points, and ideally, you want to come away with a touchdown.
He's going to be marked down at the 12-yard line. 17 yards on that play. First down, Indianapolis.
Every once in a while, it just comes down to you need somebody in the huddle to just make a play, and it wasn't a whole lot fancy here. The quarterback just dumps the ball down, a quick underneath completion, and then really it's the yards after catch that did the rest, and that's what it takes. You're not always going to have the perfect play. You're not always going to dial up the perfect play against the perfect look. Sometimes players need to make plays, and that was a good one there. Great example of first down efficiency. You don't always have to go for the big play, but put yourself in a friendly second down. Now you have equal opportunity to both run and pass.
Throwing on second down, Richardson. That one taken in. Touchdown, Colts. Greg, they take advantage of the good field position and move it downfield for the score.
When you take the field as an offense, there's a little added confidence boost, Mike, when you see yourself this close to the end zone. You get into the huddle, you're anxious to see what the next couple plays are. They're able to take advantage and end up punching it in.
Matt Gay on for the extra point. He's got it. And the Colts will take a 7-0 lead. 7-0 is our score as this kick is sent into the air. This fielded at about the 9. Now an opening past the 30. And he's brought down right at the 35-yard line. The Browns offense ready now for their second drive. They trail here by a touchdown as this drive will start with a first down. Watson keeping this on the zone read. And he'll work forward for about 4. It's second down.
Nice job by the defense. They had that one well read from the beginning, Mike. Someone's responsible for the running back, but the key here was the defender responsible for the quarterback. Stays with him, keeps him to a short game.
Here's a 2nd and 6. On the carry, this is Nick Chubb. He'll be stacked up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play.
A corner who is not only a good tackler, Mike, but a willing tackler can be a huge asset to any defense. So often they get a bad rap. They're considered just pass defenders. They want to run around. But for a guy to be able to come up and force the run and keep this to no gain, man, that makes a big difference on any defense.
He'll try and get there on the ground. Whoa! And he's going to be brought down, but not until he gets inside the 35.
You know this defense worked all week defending this quarterback as a scrambler, as a runner. But sometimes it's just hard to simulate until you see him in real life, his speed, his ability to create. We saw him get him here early on a big scramble. He's able to pick up the first down and keep the drive alive.
Break the huddle. Coming up now for 1st and 10. Watson going to give it to Chubb. And he's fighting to try to get back to the line of scrimmage, but will not do it. This is going to be a loss of a yard.
The speed and the get-off by the big interior defensive tackle, Mike. I mean, he got through there so fast, he almost took the handoff himself.
2nd and 11. From the shotgun, here's Watson. Now he'll run it. And they bring him down inside the 25-yard line. Good job breaking the pocket and going for 14 yards. And most importantly, a first down.
You know, Mike, I like everything about this play except the very end. You've already picked up good yardage. You've already picked up the first down. Now get down on the ground and protect yourself. There's no reason to take those shots.
And a good job following his blockers. A gain of 7. It'll be 2nd down. Once again, it's Chubb. And he is crushed in the backfield. Defenders firing through. Shut it down right away for a loss of yardage.
Great job by that linebacker timing his blitz. He didn't give any indication to the offense that he was coming. And he's able to get through that hole and take the ball carrier down for a loss.
Throwing on 3rd down. Watson. That's caught left side by Cooper.
I think this is one of those plays that when the ball carrier watches this back in the film room tomorrow, he's going to be a little frustrated with himself. If he could just have made that one guy miss, he picks up the first down. Instead, he gets brought down short of the sticks, and now they got a 4th down decision to make.
On 4th down, Watson. That's taken in, and he's going to have that 1st down. They didn't want to settle for 3. And now it's 1st and goal.
Offensively, landing a lot of body blows on this drive, Mike. Just the ability to steadily march the ball downfield and remain so efficient, both run and pass. As they continue to wear this defense out, they have to find a way to end this drive with points. Anything short of that, It'd be a bit of a letdown.
Here's Chubb. And he's going to go backwards on that one. They take him down back at the 6-yard line.
When you can get this level of run support out of your secondary, Mike, man, what an advantage for any defense. This defensive back clearly reads run, gets off his block, and he's able to take down the back for a loss of yards.
Njoku, the tight end, is the one in motion. One more time, it's Chubb. Looking for a seam, but will not find one. He'll take this down to the 4-yard line. Third and goal. Shotgun snap to Watson. And he will take this one across into the end zone. Deshaun Watson, touchdown Cleveland. The defense comes up with the coverage, but they cannot keep up with the speed as the quarterback scrambles to the end zone for the touchdown.
And down here in the red zone, Mike, is where I think a quarterback's legs can be the most dangerous. The defenders are trying to match backs, match tight ends and receivers, but often it's the quarterback that has no one assigned to him, and in this case, he's able to capitalize and run it in himself.
Dustin Hopkins now to add the extra point. He's got it. And the Browns will tie things up at 7-7 here in the opening quarter. Away. He fields it at the 8. Oh, he's got room past the 30. Oh, very good field position to start as the return is past the 40. The Colts offense ready to take over for their second possession. They're trying to break out of this deadlock. We are all even at 7 as they start this drive first and 10. It's Richardson. Open man downfield. It's Pittman. And he'll be out of bounds, but not before he gets inside the 35-yard line. Big gain of 27 yards. What a way to open the drive.
And really the key to this play was just how fast he was able to get through his progressions. His mind was able to process and go from 1 to 2 to 3 so quickly that he was able to get the ball to the right target on time. And I think so often those two things are different. Being open is one thing. Being open and getting the ball on time, that's what leads to success. And that's what we saw here. All week long, they stress, Mike, that we have to get as many defenders to this ball carrier as possible. They know he's going to make some guys miss. He's going to be hard to get on the ground. But you can see the effect of rallying to the ball as it had here. They're able to take him down, and they're able to do it for a loss.
A second down throw for Richardson. Looking middle, and he's got down. And this takes him into the red zone. He's brought down inside the 20-yard line. Remember, he had the touchdown on the opening drive, and here on drive 2, he gets a first down with that catch.
Not a whole lot complicated about this play, Mike. That was understanding where the holes of the defense were. Remember, in this zone coverage, you got to find green grass. Get past it.
And they get to him and finally bring him down. It will go down as a sack.
In the midst of a tight game like that, you're looking for every play that you can make to try to gain advantage. And if you can continue to get after the quarterback, disrupt the rhythm and timing of this quarterback, in the second half, That could be the difference of you being able to pull away.
On second down, Richardson. That one complete to Pierce. And he'll be taken down, and that's going to do it. That's the last play of the first quarter. So we are through one on Sunday Night Football. All even on the scoreboard. And we're back to Cleveland in a minute. Third and five. Out of shotgun, Richardson. That's to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I like the idea of taking your shot there on third down, pushing the ball downfield, looking for the touchdown. But now as it brings up fourth down, you're already this close. You're in field goal range, but do you keep that offense on the field and try to maintain possession and see if you can come away with six?
Gay's kick is good. And the Colts will break our tie and take a 10-7 lead.
And I think this is going to end up being considered a successful drive, Mike. I think obviously you would have loved to see them come down and convert and score a touchdown. But at the very least, they needed to come away with three. They were able to do that and take a lead on that field goal.
The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. To return is Naheem Hines. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. Now it's the Browns' turn as they get set to take over again on offense. This one has been tight so far. A field goal separating the two sides as this drive kicks off with first and 10. Out of the gun, Watson. A throw. Right side, taken by Njoku. Look him up on a second down and 8. Watson to throw. That's complete to Moore on the right side. And he's going to be brought down up past the 45. They gain 18 yards on that one. It's a Browns first down.
Now, this is the epitome of a really short throw and a really nice run after catch. And listen, for a quarterback, it all counts the same. You don't always have to throw the ball downfield to generate explosive plays. And these drag routes can be very, very effective.
First and 10. They'll run it straight ahead with Chubb. He'll work his way ahead for a gain of about 4. To throw on second down is Watson. He gets this one to Moore. And he will go all the way. Elijah Moore. Touchdown Browns. A terrific job all the way around, especially after the catch, Greg, to take it to the end zone for a touchdown.
I'm just so impressed by the acceleration of this receiver, Mike. He catches what is a short pass, and he's able to turn it up the field and take it all the way for 6. That is an impressive play, run after catch.
Now Hopkins on to add the extra point. He knocks it through. And the Browns are on top. It's 14-10. Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. Josh Downs now on the return. And he's brought down right at the 25-yard line. The Colts offense ready to see what they can do. Trail by four, touchdown gives them the lead. Drive begins with first and 10. From the gun, Richardson. Trying the left side and caught by Pittman. 16 yards on the game and a quick first down.
I'd like to see them do a better job here the rest of the game, Mike, just disguising the coverage from the pre-snap look to the post-snap look. And what I mean is, when you have a quarterback at this level, and what they see before the ball's in their hands is the exact same thing they see once they do get the ball, everything is just so much easier for them to process. Change the look, change the coverages, move your safeties. Make the quarterback have to process with the ball in his hand. They went to the design quarterback run, and there just wasn't a lot of space for the quarterback to operate. You could see him kind of waiting for some of the blocks to develop. Never transpired. Didn't get a whole lot going. Short game.
Looking to throw. Richardson. Able to find Pittman. It's complete.
This is one of those throws where you're hoping you do most of the damage after the catch, but give credit to the defense. Once that ball was caught, they were on him quickly, and there was nowhere for him to go after the catch.
From the gun on third down, Richardson. That's catch three just on this drive. And it gets his team a first down.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They clearly have a mismatch in their favor, and every time they've looked his way, he's continued to make big plays. If I'm this coordinator, I think I'm giving him one more shot and see if he can push this thing over the goal line and come away with six.
They'll come up first and 10 at the 40. Richardson will give it to Taylor. And that one shut down pretty quickly. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. Nothing more.
These edge rushers, they are judged by their sack totals, Mike. They love to rush the passer. They have responsibilities in the run game as well. Great job here keeping it to no gain.
He'll try again here. Second and 10. They go right back to Taylor. And he'll manage to pick up about four. That was Jordan Hicks who got him down. Third and six. Now Richardson. He gets this one complete to Pittman. How about four catches on this drive alone? Time to change the defense. This one gets him another first down.
I really like the rhythm that this offense has found. I mean, that third down, that wasn't a layup by any means, but they made it look easy. Everybody was exactly where they needed to be. The quarterback did a nice job working through his progression, saying, okay, I understand this is zone defense. I understand where the limitations of the coverage are. I'm going to get to that spot on the field as fast as I can, deliver the ball, pick up the first down.
It'll be taken down rather swiftly after a gain of just three.
It's not the big play they were hoping for, but first down efficiency, staying ahead of the chains, is what every offense is trying to find, and it brings up a manageable second down.
second and 7. Throwing is Richardson. That's in the end zone and intercepted. That's the safety, Grant Delpit. What a critical flag. Roughing the passer. It sets up first and goal. Here's Richardson. And he's in. Mo Alley-Cox. Touchdown, Indy.
Touchdown, Indianapolis.
That is a dream scenario. The offense handed the ball first and goal. And, Greg, they take it to the end zone for 6.
They're not going to have many easier drives than that, Mike. I mean, to get the ball not only in a short field but in a goal-to-go situation, you don't get a lot of those chances. You have to cash them in, and that's exactly what they were able to do.
Now Gay for the extra point. The kick is good. And the Colts move out to a 3-point edge, 17-14. The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. Here's Hines now to return. And they will finally get him down, but he gets all the way close to the 40-yard line. Browns offense getting those helmets back on, ready to head out for their next possession. They'll see if they can put something together here, beginning with 1st and 10. To throw is Watson. Oh, a lot of chances on that one. It was bouncing around, but it falls incomplete. Here's Watson now on 2nd down. There's a short throw caught by Njoku. Well, he's brought down. That pass is going to pick up 4 and bring up 3rd down. Here's Watson. To the left side, into the hands of Moore. Remember, he had the touchdown catch the last time they had the football. Here, he's got a 1st down. So, 2 minutes to play in a back-and-forth 1st half. We'll have more from Cleveland after this. Set to go now on 1st and 10. Throwing again is Watson. Right back to Moore, another grab. And good yardage there after the catch. They'll wind up with a gain of 7 on 1st down.
The receiver thought he had a nice soft spot in that zone coverage, and he settles down to give a nice target to the quarterback. But the defense had eyes on him the entire time. Secure rally tackle prevents that from turning into a big play.
He'll take a shot here, back of the end zone. And that's going to wind up uncatchable out of the back of the end zone. It's incomplete. Amari Cooper was the man he was looking for. Third down coming up.
So I like the aggressiveness of the call, but as the rest of the game unfolds, Mike, there needs to be better overall execution. A little bit cleaner. Next thing you know, they're going to hit some of those big shots.
Left side, he's got the Joku. And it looks like he's going to have a first down. Nothing fancy there. Short completion, but it yields a fresh set of downs.
Well, nothing real fancy here, Mike. Not a huge pickup, but anytime on third down, you got to know where the sticks are, who's your most reliable player, and I think everybody in this booth knows exactly what position that is. Just a little slow developing on that screen play there. It was pretty obvious to the entire defense exactly what was going on. Nobody was thinking pass. Nobody was getting back into their drops, and just nowhere for that back to go.
They'll run the draw with Chubb. And he'll get four more on this one to set up third and two. The shotgun. Here's Watson. And this is going to be incomplete. That's great work to get in there and make things difficult defensively, setting up a fourth down.
It's rare to see an offense that finds themselves trailing and say, well, their quarterback's been actually one of their biggest bright spots. Usually that doesn't go hand in hand, so it's a little surprising to see him miss a throw like that on a day where he's completed passes at a highly efficient rate.
And he's not going to get there. The defense was ready for it, and they stuff him on fourth down.
So this play by the middle linebacker is all about play recognition. Reminds me of a former teammate, Luke Kuechly. He knew the play before it was going to happen. Watch him. He diagnoses, he tracks the ball, and bang, makes a huge tackle, short of the yard to gain, forces the turnover on downs.
So they come to the line for first down and 10. Throwing, Richardson. He'll get this one to his safety valve. Complete. A very nice open field tackle there. He could not get free and gains nothing. On second down, Richardson. That's the tight end, Mo Alley Cox. And they'll mark him down just shy of the 40. It's a gain of 10 yards. That's good for a Colts first down.
Well, we'll give a little credit here defensively. Even though they allow the first down, we've seen defenses really struggle bringing this big tight end to the ground, and they didn't allow him to pick up a bunch of yards after contact, but he was able to get just enough to pick up the first down.
From the 39, here's a first and 10. Now Richardson. Short pass taken in by the tight end. After the catch, he gets that forward for a gain of 9. The Colts will signal for their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go until halftime. Second and a yard. Shotgun, Richardson. they'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
A rare miss for a quarterback that we've seen really come out on fire throughout this entire contest. I mean, his completion percentage, Mike, is well above league average, and frankly, it's really the biggest reason why they find themselves out front.
They'll look to pick this up, third and a yard. To throw, it's Richardson. They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
Gotta give a lot of credit here to the coverage unit, Mike. There was plenty of time for the quarterback to work through his progression. I thought the protection was actually pretty solid. But at the end of it, there was just nowhere to go, and he had no choice but to just throw that ball away.
Well, that'll bring up fourth down, and that'll bring on Rigoberto Sanchez to punt. Nyheim Hines back deep for the Browns.
The Browns take over right at the end. Pat their own slip on your blood. Pat will show that this shiver. We won't tell you that this shiver.
This drive starts at the 21. It's first and 10. And they'll elect not to run another play. Instead, just take a knee and take this on into the locker room. So we reach halftime, and the visiting Colts are on top as we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
All right, Michael, thanks very much as we welcome you into our downtown Orlando studios and the EA Sports halftime report. This one's been as good as advertised. Just a field goal separating these two teams. This was a very level first half, and I'd expect to see more of the same after the break.
Okay, Coach, thanks a bunch. We'll see which team's adjustment's going to pay dividends here. Likely going to play a big role in who wins this one. Three points, all that separates these two sides as half number two kicks off. On the return, this is down. He'll get this past the 20 before he's brought down shy of the 25-yard line. The Colts offense and Anthony Richardson getting ready for their next drive. And we run you through the highlights here. It has been a very big performance from the quarterback position, instrumental in leading and executing, and now trying to finish strong and take his team to the finish line. They'll come up here first and 10. On first down, they'll start with Taylor. It'll take this to about the 28. That's Greg Newsome in to make the stop. That one complete to Pierce. And that's a first down. It will be a gain of 8.
Really nice job there to move the chains early in this drive, but now as they approach midfield, continue to keep your foot on the gas. Don't get conservative. Don't start sitting on the ball. Cross midfield and go. Anytime you find yourself in your opponent's side of the field, you have to be thinking points.
This throw right side, pulled in by Pittman. And he's going to be taken down right at midfield. A pickup of 14 on that one. That's good for a Colts first down.
Every quarterback's dream is, can I get the ball out of my hand as fast as possible and get it to a guy that can do the rest after the catch? And it seems like nowadays throughout the entire league, the best offenses thrive in yards after the catch.
On first down, it's Richardson. To the tight end, and he fits it in on the corner route. And they bring him down there, but it is inside the 10. It is going to be first and goal. A big gainer for Indianapolis to gain a 43 yards.
If you want to score points at a high level in the NFL, you have to generate explosive plays. And after that big chunk pass play, they find themselves now down there in the red zone. And this is where you have to finish drives.
Now a chance to pay off that big play. They have it first and goal. Richardson. That is caught to the goal line and in. Josh Downs. Touchdown, Indianapolis. That his second touchdown tonight.
You can just see the comfort, Mike, that this offense continues to play with. The early momentum in the first half has carried here after the break, and you can see this group just slowly starting to pull away.
And I'm thinking, Greg, about the guys on the other side. You're waiting at halftime, that other offense waiting to get back on the field. What happens? They come right out, extend the lead, and now the task gets a lot tougher for this second half.
Gay to add the PAT. It's up and good. And the Colts go up by 10. 24-14 is their lead. Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. This taken in at the 8-yard line. And a decent return there. He'll get this up just shy of the 30. The Browns offense trotting back out for their first involvement of this second half. The deficit is 10, 24-14. So work to do as they come up for first and 10. Start on the ground with Chubb. Has an opening past the 40. They'll mark him down up at the 44-yard line. It's a gain of 16, and very quickly a first down.
Finding yourself down here, multiple scores in the second half. The defense is going to give you some friendly run looks, so don't be afraid to mix it in there. But if you're going to find yourself coming back from this deficit, you're going to have to do it primarily through the air with just a little bit of mix of the run.
The tackle's going to be made down at the 40-yard line. He's got a touchdown on the books from earlier, and that catch gets him a first down.
Whatever they've talked about in the locker room at the halftime break seems to have worked. They've come out with a new established energy. You could see it when they took the field. Now this offense seems to be building on it, because with that chunk play, just a little bit of rhythm that they can build off of. They got a long way to go to get back into this game, but so far off to a good start.
A quick slant, looked in by Moore. And he'll get about 8 on that one, most of it coming after the catch. It's second down.
Similar to a tight end, the slot receiver is often considered the safety blanket. He makes all the difficult catches, tends to be a little bit more around the line of scrimmage, and so far today, he's certainly lived up to that reputation.
On play action, it's Watson. That's deep for the back of the end zone.
So, of course, you prefer to connect on that throw, but think about it like this, Mike. The more they continue to test this defense downfield, the more it's going to open up some of those shorter passes underneath.
Now a third and 2. Off play action, here's Watson. They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
You can't fault the quarterback on this one, Mike. He really didn't even have much of an opportunity. By the time he hit the top of his drop and got his eyes downfield, The defense was all over him, and he really had no choice but to just get that ball out of his hand and live to play another snap.
On fourth down, Watson. Taking off, he'll try to get there. And he's going to have a Browns first down, it would appear. Yes, he does, by a full yard. They get the conversion on fourth and two.
Fourth down. There's no throwing the ball away. There's no giving yourself up. If you're going to turn yourself into a runner, you got to go get it. And that's exactly what the quarterback does here. He's able to put his head down, put his body on the line, pick up the first down, and keep this drive alive.
He'll be taken down rather swiftly after a gain of just three.
Recognizing the blitz is just the first step in the process for a quarterback, understanding who you can account for with the protection and then who you can't account for. That's where your hot receiver comes in. He points to his receiver, who the defender they're hot off of. That guy comes, gets the ball out of his hand, and results in a completion.
And that's going to be a first down. A pickup of nine.
Receiver just finds himself in a really nice groove, and there's these weird times in the game, Mike, where it just seems like every ball comes your way, every play they call, you're wide open, and you just find yourself in one of those grooves that athletes talk about. So they got to continue to ride the hot hand, because right now on that field, there's no mistaking who it is.
And he finds some space, tackled after a gain of seven on first down. Here's a second and three forthcoming. On the handoff, this is Chubb. And the Browns are going to have a first and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
I think this second down call, Mike, they were hoping that at worst, they had themselves set up for a third down and short. But there's no need for third down. He was able to get enough on second, and they get a fresh set of downs.
Off the bootleg, here's Watson. And he will fight his way to the end zone. Deshaun Watson, touchdown Cleveland. Greg, sometimes we say it too often, that was an important drive. That one really felt important for them to edge a little bit closer.
Yeah, now the question is, Mike, yeah, the offense does their job, but can the defense get a stop? They've got to continue to get the ball back to their offense, let them build on that previous drive, because they've still got some work to do.
Hopkins now to take on the extra point. His kick is good, and the Browns cut the lead to three, 24-21. Kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. This is going to be taken in at the three, and he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line.
Well, he had such a great first half throwing the football. There's no reason to think, Mike, coming out here for the start of the third, that anything's going to change. He's picked up right where he left off, and the numbers are indicative of just how well he's played.
Set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. From the gun, Richardson. And this one is caught by Pierce. And they'll mark him down just shy of the 40. That one good for a dozen. And a very quick first down. Taylor gets it out of the pistol. And
and he's going to be stopped in his tracks. He'll lose a couple of yards on that one.
Every team makes an emphasis on winning first down, but as a defense, when you're able to take them back for a loss, second and long, you can really become more of a pass-centric defense and really tips the scales into your favor.
A second down throw for Richardson. That's complete to his running back, Taylor.
There's a lot of ways to get the ball in the hands of your running backs, and it's not always by just handing it to them. In this case, it's a simple check down, picks up a good game, brings up third down.
Now, Richardson. Coming open is Pierce. It's on target. His second grab on this drive, good for 11 yards, but most importantly, a first down.
Now, so far here today, putting points on the board certainly hasn't been a problem, and plays like that are why. Think about it, Mike. Sometimes you just have to take what the defense gives you and not force something that's not there, and that mid-range pass results in a fresh set of downs.
On play action, Richardson. To the right side here, pass is caught, and it'll be taken down at the 25-yard line. That catch puts him over the 100-yard mark here tonight, and it gives the team a first down. So both teams trade touchdowns in that frame as we get through the end of the third quarter. And Sunday Night Football continues after this. Richardson to throw here on first and 10. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
The offense goes from feeling really good about the previous play with a real nice pickup to then on the ensuing play ending up going the complete opposite direction. Really nice job here by the defense immediately getting back on track. What do the coaches say? Just play the next play. That's exactly what they did.
Work to do now as they come up on second and long. Here's Richardson. They'll set up the screen to Taylor. Is Richardson. And this ball incomplete on third down.
And up until this point, this has been an incredibly efficient game from this quarterback. I mean, it's hard to think here we are in the second half, and that's only his second incomplete pass. So finally, the defense is able to do something to disrupt his timing and finally try to get him out of this groove.
And this one right down the middle. It's good. A big 3 points as they extend their fourth quarter lead.
And this is what you want. I mean, you clearly have the advantage, but you want to continue to apply pressure. Can you score every time you get the ball? They're able to do that here. They tack on three and extend their lead.
Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. Here's Hines now to return. They'll get this up past the 20, and that's where they'll set up shop. The Browns offense ready to take over possession of the football. The deficit, 6 points. A touchdown here would be mighty nice for the offense. See what they can do on this drive. First and 10.
the shotgun. Here's Watson. That's caught left side by Cooper.
Well, it wasn't the most exciting throw of the game, but I want you to watch, Mike, is the suddenness of the route runner. Change of speed, change of direction. Those are the qualities of great route runners, and this guy's certainly one of them.
They'll work now on second and four. Oh, maybe a free play as he'll look to throw it. That's over the middle to his tight end, Njoku. And that's going to be a first down. A pickup of nine.
That penalty is declined.
There. He's back to the original line. No gain on that.
The integrity of the defense, Mike, is based on every defender holding their gap. That's exactly what we saw out of this defensive tackle. Not only did he hold his gap, he's able to shed his block and make the play.
They'll keep it on the ground. And a good run there on second down. A pickup of seven. It'll bring up third and three.
Very positive returns on that run. I mean, really, the only thing not to like is that they weren't able to move the chains. But you know what? The way he ran there, I think they go right back to him and see if he has even a bigger carry in him.
Watson now on third down. Pressure gets there, and down he goes.
Defense came out in a soft zone, and I think it caught the quarterback a little off guard. He was trying to attack them downfield. By the time he was able to get through his progression to his check down, he ran out of time, and that's all the pass rush needed to get into the backfield and bring him down.
So on fourth down, here's Corey Bohorquez to kick it away. And back deep, it is Josh Downs. And no return fourth cover. It's a touchback, and will come out to the 20-yard line. Here's first and 10. He'll start this on the ground. It's Taylor. He did a good job of making one man miss, but could not get away from this defense in the end. It turns into a loss of yardage.
At this stage in the fourth quarter, great job by the defense, understanding exactly what the offense is trying to do. They're trying to bleed the clock, shorten the game. They completely sold out to stop the run, able to take them down for a loss.
They'll go again here with Taylor. And he'll get a couple here, but it's going to set up a third and long. Richardson going to look to throw. He's got his man. Right side. It's complete. 12 yards on that hookup. First down, Indianapolis.
These curl routes. He's been running these routes since he was a young kid in Pop Warner football, and I like to call it pulling the string. You've got the defender thinking you're going downfield, and you stick that foot in the ground. Work back to the quarterback, friendly to the ball, and really nice job picking up the first down.
Richardson to throw it here on first down. That's caught inside by Pittman on the slant. A Here's second and three to go. On the give, this is Taylor. And nothing on that one. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it.
Well, that second down play call is not real fancy, but at this point, Mike, they're in a battle with the clock. How much time can they run off and try to protect this lead? But now it brings up a pretty interesting third down. Can they keep the ball and finish this thing on offense, or are they going to have to punt it away and have their defense finish the game?
They'll try and run for this. It's Taylor. He is going to have a Colts first down as they move the chains on third down. So 2 minutes left to play in the second half. Greg and I back on EA Sports after this. Now it's Richardson. He'll keep it. And maybe the quarterback should have given that one away. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Is here. We have another stoppage. Timeout called by the defense with 1:53 remaining. They'll drop to throw. Looking middle, and he's got downs. And he'll try to get to the marker, but he's going to wind up a yard or two short. The Colts about to kick this one away. As they try to play the field position game here, protecting a fourth quarter lead. And no chance of a run back here. This one's going to sail out of bounds. The home team's offense ready to get back at it. They'll begin with first and 10. Out of the gun, Watson. That's taken in by Chubb. And good yardage there after the catch. They'll wind up with a gain of 7 on first down.
All right, so there's really three areas that a modern NFL running back has to excel at. Number one, the traditional handoffs. Yes, you have to operate out of the backfield like a traditional running back. Number two, you have to be excellent and reliable in pass protection. And maybe bigger than all of them, you have to be at least serviceable out of the backfield in the passing game.
A pickup of 15 in the air. First down, Cleveland.
We spent so much time talking about these receivers. How fast do they run, Mike? How high do they jump? But so often, the guys that have the most success in the NFL, it's the mental part of the game. It allows them to create separation, find soft spots in the defense, attack defenders. It's exactly what he's able to do here, and really nice connection. All right, so this is why you get paid the big bucks. These are the possessions as a quarterback you need to deliver for your team. Everybody talks about 2 minute. Everybody drills it every single week. But when it comes down to this moment in the game, your quarterback needs to be on point, and after that first down incompletion, it just makes things that much harder.
Throw is caught by Cooper on the right side. And nice work there after the catch. He's a little short of the first down after a gain of 7. They come to the line for this one. Third down, needing three. Watson to throw again. He's got his man complete. That's Judy. First time they've looked his way all game long. He comes through with the grab and a first down.
It's pretty evident, Mike, when a quarterback and his wide receiver are operating on the exact same page. The anticipation, the timing, the accuracy of the, both the route and the ball. And when they're working together like this, that's the definition of teach tape.
There's a short throw caught by Njoku.
The drag route is such a good way to get the ball early into the hands of your tight end and take some pressure off the quarterback and give him an easy completion. The size and the athleticism allows them to try to pick up more yards, but do it after the catch.
Here's second down. Again, it's Watson. That is incomplete, so the task gets more difficult. Time for maybe two plays. That's it.
This is one of those situations that plays directly into the hands of the defense because, think, Mike, they know this offense has to be one-dimensional. This has to be a pass. So what do? They bring in extra defensive backs. They clog up the back end. And at the end of the day, there's just nowhere for the offense to go with the ball.
That is caught. And he won't quite make it to the pylon, but he's out of bounds right around the one-yard line. They'll break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. Here we go. One final play. And that's going to be incomplete. The defense holds here in the final minute. And they're going to get out of here with a victory. So this one, a win for the visiting Colts. They're able to get the job done in front of a hostile crowd as they come away with the victory. So that'll just about do it for Greg Olson and our entire team. I'm Mike Tirico. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we wish you a good night from Cleveland.